Why do we suddenly need AI? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. For decades, most people have known AI stands for artificial intelligence. That's plain and simple. I'm asking about the modern AI that is suddenly a worldwide phenomenon that is attracting hundreds of billions of dollars of investments in huge multi-acre AI centers with thousands of employees and huge electrical power requirements that almost demands a dedicated nuclear reactor. Why does the world suddenly need all of this? Okay, you may not like the approach I'm going to take, but I'm going to draw a comparison. Hear me out. Step one, I'm going to rewrite your question. Why do we suddenly need the automobile? I'm asking about the modern horseless carriage that is suddenly a worldwide phenomenon that's attracting hundreds of millions of dollars of investments in huge multi-acre manufacturing plants with thousands of employees and huge power requirements that almost demands we start drilling and drilling and drilling for more oil to run them all. Why does the world suddenly need all of this? Yes, that's a question I'm certain was being asked by many shortly after the turn of the previous century, say the 1920s. The automobile was the new big thing, and it was changing society forever. Many, I'm sure, were asking why we needed this newfangled contraption. We seemed to be doing just fine without it after all. Now, the answer to this turn of the previous century version of your question is the same as my answer to your question about AI. We don't. We don't need any of it. We could have lived in a world without the automobile. In fact, there are plenty of folks today who would say it probably would even be a better world for some definition of better. We could live in a world without AI. The question we don't know the answer to is, do we want to? Would it be a better world? In hindsight, there's a pretty powerful argument that society and even the world is better off with automobiles than without them. Yep, there are plenty of downsides. Pollution, industrial waste, massive acres of payments, accidents, and more. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. And while we're making progress on some of these, the fact is that the automobile continues to have a negative impact on society, even all these years later. And yet, it's offset by the massive positive effects that you can drive anywhere at any time, and that it's even marginally affordable is absolutely amazing. It's enabling you to live a life you simply could not have imagined pre-automobile. Quick trips to the grocery store, to cross-country road trips to visit family and friends or take part in activities you might never have even heard of in the past, are just the tip of the iceberg. Expand that vision to include the massive enablement of commerce and trade, and once again, we find we're living in a world our 1920s counterpart simply could not have imagined. Much of what the automobile has enabled is so core to what we are and how we live, we just take it all for granted these days. We didn't need it, but we're better off because of it. Now, I'm not saying that we'll be better off with AI than without it. We don't know. We're still in the middle of it all happening, and we don't yet know all the impact it will have. What the world will look like in just a few years is uncertain for a variety of reasons, AI being just one of them. Will it help or hinder? Will the changes it makes and the impact it brings be a net positive or negative? We just don't know. And there are people at both ends of that spectrum who believe strongly in either its salvation or its impending doom. Just as I'm certain, there were those who felt the same way about the automobile back in the day. But it's just impossible to say what the future truly holds. My bet is on the net positive. There will be downsides to AI. There already are, be it environmental impact, societal impact, accidents, more. Just as with the automobile, there will be some massive mistakes and spectacular failures. and there will be progress. Those massive mistakes have passed into history. The automobile, while continually being refined to this day, is an assumed staple of society and something we now all take for granted. My expectation is that AI will eventually fall into this category. I won't even say I know what it'll look like because, again, it's too early to say. But I also believe it will continue to be refined and improved upon, including actions to mitigate the negative impacts we've already identified. I expect that someday it, too, will be something we all take for granted. Do we need it? No. Could our lives be better because of it? Very possibly so. Only time will tell. So please, don't dismiss AI just because you don't understand it or don't see a need for it. Many of the things we take for granted these days started out exactly the same way. Work to understand it as best you can. Hold its creators accountable, for sure. It's with our participation that AI can be molded into something we'd consider a net positive years from now. Simply dismissing it, or just railing against it, takes that power away from you. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/183047. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.